Hello friends, I am Vidya Patel, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering in Sharad Institute of Technology, College of Engineering, Yatra. Today, we are going to continue the lecture on pressure vessel. The remaining part of the pressure vessel we are going to conduct here, that is enclosures, openings in pressure vessel, area by using area compensation method, and one problem to understand the calculations by using area compensation method of a pressure vessel. Okay, from that first we see the enclosures. Enclosures are that are the formed heads which are used as enclosures for a cylindrical pressure vessels. There are two types of enclosures. First is the domed heads and second is the conical heads. These domed heads are further classified into three groups, that is hemispherical, semi-ellipsoidal and torus-spherical as shown in figure. Here in figure we see that figure A is the hemispherical head, figure B for the semi-ellipsoidal head, and third is the torus-spherical head. These are the domed heads. Here RI is the radius of inner diameter, inner radius, and di is the inner diameter, du is the outer diameter, and t is the wall thickness. Here for a semi-ellipsoidal head, sf is the straight portion, length of the straight portion, and here in a torus spherical head, l is the inside crown radius, okay, length of the inside crown radius, okay. The thickness of the hemispherical head is given, t is equal to pi ri divided by 2 sigma t efficiency minus 0.2 pi plus ca. Ca is the corrosion allowance, okay, and ri is the inner radius of the cylindrical shell. The thickness of the semi-ellipsoidal head is given by t is equal to pi di divided by 2 sigma t efficiency minus 0.2 pi plus ca, and the length of the straight portion sf is calculated as sf is equal to 3t or 20 mm, whichever is more, that is considered as a sf. And the thickness of the torus spherical head is given by t is equal to 0.885 pi capital L divided by sigma t efficiency minus 0.1 pi plus ca, and we realize the inside crown radius. Okay. The knuckle radius RI is taken as 6% of the crown radius. Here RI is equal to 0.06 into capital L, where L is the crown radius, should not be greater than the outside diameter of the cylindrical shell. Therefore, L is always less than outer diameter of the shell. Next is the conical section. The second type is a conical section, and the thickness of this conical head or conical section is calculated as t is equal to pi di divided by 2 cos alpha sigma t efficiency minus 0.6 pi plus ca, that is corrosion allowance. Here alpha is the half the apex angle, as shown in figure, is usually less than 30 degree. Here di is the inner diameter and du is the outer diameter and t is the thickness. Hemispherical, semi ellipsoidal heads are used for tall vertical towers because they are practically free from discontinuities. In such cases, the cost of the top end closure is only a small part of the total cost of the pressure vessel, and also the space is not limiting factor for the vertical pressure vessels. The torus spherical heads are more economical than other types of domed heads, and owing to their compact construction, they are used for horizontal pressure vessels such as tankers for water, milk, petrol and diesel and kerosene. They are also used for small vertical pressure vessels. Now we see one example related to that, that is a horizontal pressure vessel. Pressure vessel consists of cylindrical shell enclosed by hemispherical ends, and the volumetric capacity of the vessel should be approximately 2 m³, and the length should not be exceed 3 m. Assuming the thickness negligibly small compared with the overall dimensions of the vessels and determine the internal diameter and the length of the cylindrical shell. The pressure vessel is fabricated from the steel plates with the yield strength of 255 Newton per mm square, and the weld joint efficiency factor is 0.85, and corrosion allowance is 2 mm, and the pressure vessel is subjected to an operating pressure of 2 MPa. We have to calculate the thickness of the cylindrical shell and the hemispherical enclosures. For that, first we note down the given data, that is operating pressure is given as a 2 MPa, efficiency is 0.85, yield strength 255 Newton per mm square, corrosion allowance is 2 mm, volume is 2 meter cube, and length is given 3 meter. First, we have to calculate the diameter and length of the cylindrical shell. For that, here we consider the formula for that. L is equal to Di divided by 2 plus L1 plus Di divided by 2. Di divided by 2 plus Di divided by 2, that is Di plus L1. Here L1 is the length of the cylindrical shell. Here in figure we can see that L1 is the length of the cylindrical shell, and Di by 2 and Di by 2, these are the two main diameter of the internal diameter of the shell. Okay, so we take only Di plus L1 here to calculate length and diameter. Okay, so length is given here, that is 3 meter. So we consider 3 meter here. So total L1 is equal to 3 minus Di. This is equation 1. Also volume is given here, that is 2 meter cube. We consider this volume 2 meter cube in this equation, and then we got the equation for that. V is equal to pi di square L1 divided by 4 plus pi di cube divided by 6. Here where we put the value of volume 2, then we got this. After simplifying the expression, above expression, we got the value, that is di cube minus 9 di square plus 24 divided by pi is equal to 0. This above equation is solved by only trial and error method, and the values of the given as well values are given as the following table as the di, and that is 1. After trial and error method, we calculated by putting in this equation di cube minus 9 di square plus 24 divided by pi. After putting in this equation, we got the value from first these values are minus values, and last for the diameter di on di 0.94, we got the positive value. So for the root of the cubic equation between 0.94 and 95, we have to take. So because there is a plus and minus sign changes, so for di we take the value 0.95 meters. Okay, for to calculate length, we put this di value in equation 1, then we got L1 is equal to 2.05 meter, and putting this L1 and di value in volume equation, we got the total volume as a 1.902 meter cube. Okay, in step number 2, we are going to calculate the thickness of the cylindrical shell. For that, we consider the design pressure, we have to calculate design pressure, which is given by Pi is equal to 1.05 into 2. 2 is the operating pressure, which is already given in the problem. So Pi is equal to 2.1 MPa or Newton per mm square. Okay. Then sigma t is the yield strength divided by factor of safety, and factor of safety is given 1.5 here. So putting these values, values of yield strength and factor of safety, we got the value of sigma t here, that is 1.170 Newton mm square. Okay. From equation 22.29, again we have to, here we are going to calculate the thickness of T is equal to Pi di divided by 2 sigma T, efficiency minus Pi plus Ca, and putting these all values, we got the thickness value, that is 8.95, we take as a 9 mm. In step number 3, we are going to calculate thickness of the hemispherical head. Okay, By putting by using the formula for the thickness of the hemispherical head, we calculate thickness as a 5.46, that is 6 mm. Okay. By using these all formulas for the by taking considering the shape of the head or enclosure, we can calculate the all values here. Okay. Next is the openings in pressure vessel. The openings are provided pressure vessel. This could be in inlet and outlet pipe connections, or manholes or handholes connections for the pressure gauges, temperature gauges, and safety valves. The openings are circular, elliptical, or abroad. The inner diameter of the manhole is generally 380 mm, and such openings are designed by using the area compensation method. Now, in figure shows the principle of the area compensation in figure 22.424. In that figure, in first figure A, where the in openings the area is removed, and in figure B, the area is added. The basic principle for the area compensation method is when the opening is cut in pressure vessel and area is removed from the shell, and it must be reinforced by an equal amount of area near the opening, and the area removed should be equal to the area added. The area is added by providing the reinforcing pad in the form of angular circular plate around the opening, and it should be noted that in this method we are considering the cross section area in the form of a rectangular strip. Okay. Here also in figure 22.25 they are showing the area compensation for the nozzle. Okay. Here the reinforcing pad is added here, and there is a shelf wall. Okay. And here there is a nozzle. Here CA is the corrosion allowance is kept here. Okay. Here also there is a corrosion allowance, and these are H1, H2. These are the height are given, and these the thickness are also given. It is not always necessary to replace the actually removed area of the metal. The plate shell and the nozzle are usually thicker than they would be required to withstand pressure. This partially compensates for the loss of area in the opening. So we have to calculate first area. For that, area is calculated by using formula D into TR. Here the area A is the area of metal removed in the corroded condition in mm square, and D is the inner diameter of the openings in corroded condition. Here D is again calculated by using formula Di plus 2Ca in mm. Di is the inner diameter, that is nominal, of nozzle in mm, and Tr is the required thickness of the cylindrical shell in mm. The required thickness Ti is calculated by using formula Tr is equal to Pi Di divided by 2 sigma T efficiency minus Pi. Okay. After the next process for the area compensation is that in metal used for reinforcement should be located in vicinity of the opening, and the limiting dimensions x is parallel to the wall of the cylindrical shell, and that is given by x is equal to small t, or x is equal to di divided by 2 plus t plus ti minus 3c, and whichever is maximum, that is considered as a x is equal to d here. Okay, the limiting dimensions h1 and h2 are parallel to the nozzle wall, and that are calculated by h1 or h2 is equal to 2.5 in bracket t minus ca, or h1 or h2 is equal to 2.5 tn minus ca, and whichever is minimum, that is considered here. Okay, here t is the total thickness of the wall of the cylindrical shell in mm, and Tn is the total thickness of the nozzle wall in mm. The area A1 of excess thickness in vessel wall, which is available for the reinforcement, is given by A1 is equal to 2x minus d in bracket t minus tr minus ca, and area A2 excess thickness in the nozzle wall is given by A2 is equal to 2H1 Tn in bracket Tn minus Trn minus Ca. Here Trn is the thickness required for the nozzle wall to be able to withstand the pressure. Okay, so TRN is calculated by using formula as PIDI divided by 2 sigma T efficiency minus PI. The area A3 of the inside extension of the nozzle is given by using formula A3 is equal to 2H2 TN minus 2CA. Okay, the total area available for the reinforcement is A1, A2 and A3. Here we see the area, that is A1, A2 and A3. These are the three areas, and again here the reinforcing pad for the area A4 is shown, that is used when the submission of A1, A2 and A3 is greater than A, is always required greater than A, but in some cases the submission of A1, A2, A3 is less than A, that time we have to add the reinforcing pad as the area A4 is required, and for that A4 is equal to A minus in bracket A1 plus A2 and plus A3 are as a taken. That's why here is shown the reinforcing pad also shown here in this figure. Okay, sometimes reinforcing pad of area equal to A is used for the opening to avoid the detailed calculations, and this results in oversized reinforcement. Now we see one example for that, how to calculate the dimensions of the pad or how to calculate the areas, okay, that which are the removed or which are the added. For that, first I read one statement of the example, that is, a pressure vessel consists of a cylindrical shell with an inner diameter of 1500 mm and a thickness of 20 mm. It is provided with a nozzle with an inner diameter of 250 mm and a thickness of 15 mm. The yield strength of the material for the shell and nozzle is 200 N/mm² and the design pressure is 2.5 MPa. The extension of the nozzle inside the vessel is 15 mm and the corrosion allowance is 2 mm. While the weld joint efficiency is 0.85 and neglecting the area of welds, we have to determine the whether or not the reinforcement pad is required for the opening, and if so, determine the dimensions of the pad made from a plate of 15 mm thickness. Okay, first we note down the given data. That is, for cylindrical shell, they are given inner diameter that is 1500 mm, thickness 20 mm, and for nozzle diameter is inner diameter is given to 250 mm, and TL is required. Thickness for the nozzle is given 15 mm, H2 is given 15 mm, and PI for the inner pressure is given 2.5 MPa. Yield strength is given as a 200 N/mm². And CA, that is corrosion allowance, is given 2 mm, and efficiency is given 0.85. And for pad, if pad is required, that time they have to use the T thickness for the pad is T is equal to 15 mm. Okay, now in first step we have to calculate the area of removed metal. Okay, and for that in area compensation method, step by step we have to calculate the things, that is sigma T required thickness. Okay, first we calculate sigma T, that is tangential or tensile stresses, that is by using the formula yield strength divided by factor of safety. Okay, if I use here yield strength is given 200 and factor of safety is 1.5, calculating we got the sigma T is 133.33 N/mm². After getting that, we calculate the required teeth. For required teeth which is removed, that is PIDI divided by 2 sigma T efficiency minus PI. That required teeth, the value of required teeth we got, that is 16.73 mm. Here then we have to calculate the diameter and the area, that is main diameter D is calculating DI plus 2CA, and area D into TR. By calculating D as a 254 mm, and A is area is equal to 4249.42 mm². Okay, after calculating the area of removed metal, we have to calculate the area available for the reinforcement. Okay, and for that purpose we have to calculate TRN, that is required thickness for the nozzle, that is PIDI divided by 2 sigma t efficiency minus PI. By putting these all values, we got the value of TRN is equal to 279 mm. Okay, the limiting dimensions x is the higher of the following two values, whichever is higher we consider that value here. Here first x is equal to d, and x is equal to ti divided by 2 plus t plus tn minus 3 ca. By calculating this value we got x is equal to 154 mm, and here the two values x is equal to t and x is equal to this formula. By calculating both values, the maximum value is x is equal to 254 mm, so we take x is equal to 254 mm. Okay, the limiting dimensions for h1 is the lower of the following two values. Okay, so first h1 is equal to 2.5 t minus ca, and second h1 is 2.5 tn minus ca. Here by calculating both h1 values, we here 45 mm and 32.5 mm. We select the h1 which is lower of the following lower of the these two values. So lower value is 32.5 mm, so we select the lower value as h1, that is 32.5 mm. okay, and h2 is the 15 mm. okay, the areas available for the reinforcement within the above limits, that is a, we have to calculate a1, a2 and a3 value by using these formulas. A1, we got the A1 is equal to 322.58 mm square, A2 as a 663.65 mm square, and A3 as a 330 mm square. Okay, by adding these three areas values, A1 plus A2 plus A3, we got 1316.23 mm square. Okay, now for the selection of pad, first we see calculate the area of pad, and for that we have to see that the value of A1, A2, A3 is greater than or less than total area of the pad. Here we see that for the for A1, A2 and A3 is less than the total area of the pad. That's why we have to there is a necessity of the reinforcing pad. So the area of the reinforcing pad A4 is given by A4 is equal to total area minus A1 plus A2 plus A3. Okay, so here we calculated A4 as a 2933.19 mm square. Okay, now we have to calculate the dimensions of the pad. For that, first we have to calculate, they are the in problem they are given the thickness of the plate of the 15 mm thickness we have to take. So we take a reinforcing pad is a 15 mm, and therefore the width of the pad is given by area divided by thickness, that is W is width is equal to 195.55 as a, we take as a 200 mm as a width of that pad. Okay, so the inner diameter of the pad is equal to the outer diameter of the nozzle. So 250 plus 30 is equal to 280 mm is the diameter, and outer diameter of the pad is 280 plus 200, that is 480 mm. Okay, so this way we calculate the dimensions of the pad, and also the area removed of the metal, and how to reinforcement is required or not. It is all these things we learn in this problem. Okay, thank you.